Alex, you've been my best friend for 20 years. I don't know what I would do without you. I literally would not want to live. But I don't have to think about that ever again, because I get to spend the rest of my life
with you. I object! Don't do this! You told me yourself that you don't even know if you still love him, and that he let himself go, and that... that the sex was bad.
Hey, man! My Nana's here.
Dave. Sorry. I can't do this.
Oh, Dave just texted me. Okay, he says he doesn't want to talk, but that he's all good in the hood.
Whoa. What?
And unless I seek my source for some definitive, closer I am to fire.
Alex? Oh, hey guys. What's up?
Hey, how are you doing, sweetie?
Great, really great. I'm kicking ass. Been doing lots of stuff. Taking online yoga, meeting great people. They're calling me Bodhi, which is awesome because of Point Break. Been watching that a lot. Right? Totally good. Holds up. What happened to Lori Petty, right? Oh, I invented a new drink.
Ooh.
Who wants to try a gin smoothie?
Crazy. Ooh.
A little bit of this, a lot of that. Sidebar Penny, thanks to the blender. It's awesome. I don't want to get some sex. I want to get some married. I don't get it, you guys. Did she say the sex was bad?
Oh, yeah, every relationship
in passing. I just always thought it was her fault.
Let's go get you some food.
I just ate 3 French bread pizzas and most of the world's largest chocolate bride. I left the ham to hold.
Okay.
Guys, I'm okay. I'm good. I'm just gonna kick back, you know, recharge the batteries. Besides, I got a ton of thank you notes to write.
Darkness reigns. Hope gurgles out its dying breath. Mm-mm. Thank you for the beautiful crock pot. Okay, you can't send this. Mm-mm.
It's a rough draft. Guys, I'm gonna be fine, all right? I just need a little me time, you know, a little D time. Besides, Alex's next move is probably gonna be to call, so I should stay close to the phone.
She's definitely gonna call.
She went on the honeymoon with the rollerblade guy.
Somebody get me some pants.
I can't wait to be 26. I feel like nobody really takes you seriously when you're still in high school.
Waitress, another water when you get a chance.
That bitch young.
Say something.
So, where'd you two lovebirds meet? J-date.
We instantly connected.
Oh, I thought you had to be Jewish to be in that thing.
I am Jewish.
No, I was talking about Penny.
Hey,
he's also Jewish. Yeah, all right. 26-year-old Jew. Anything else I need to know, Penny Pen?
Just how to read emails labeled urgent party dates.
Years ago.
You know what, Todd? Dave is right. Things change. You have to work at the relationship. Don't shower twice a week and only focus on your stuff in bed.
Okay.
I am a very caring lovemaker.
Yes.
Here we go. You know,
nice work, Al. You're the Michael Jordan of destroying friendships.
Well, you're the Michael Jordan of banging underage sluts. I'm 18, slut. And who's Michael Jordan? God, your friends are all so immature.
We are back together. Just kidding. I still hate her.
Look at our little Dave Rose, making friends.
Bet you $5 he's telling her about the time he ran across Michigan Ave to save that puppy.
No way. He's telling the story from high school where he picked up that fumble and ran it back for a touchdown. And boom! Football. There it is. Pay up, player.
Hold up. That's a puppy dog.
Oh! Let's hope it was a football or else we have not heard the complete story about the puppy.
When's the next time you're seeing her?
Saturday night.
Perfect. Text her, change it to Wednesday. The least sexy night of the week.
I was surprised you decided to switch plans to tonight. I didn't know we were quite there yet.
My Saturdays are getting kind of booked, but wait, where yet?
Happy birthday!
It's your birthday!
Everybody, this is Dave!
I feel like all
these girls look like Jane.
Yep. It's like they took the roof off a Tory Burch store and emptied it into this apartment.
What's Tory Burch?
She's a designer. It's kind of preppy, boho chic meets up to... Are you sure you're gay?
Are you sure you're not gay?
Okay, yeah. So I have the best story. This is insanity. We're at Ungo having brunch.
Oh my God, snore. Cheese skank. Have you ever told a story? I'll take it from here. Okay, cut to. Cute waiter walks up, right? And Little Miss Push-Up Bra is so eager to flirt with him that she spits up her scrambled eggs on his pants. What? I'm like, say it, don't spray it, you stupid clumsy bitch.
You're such a clumsy bitch.
You are a clumsy bitch.
This has been the best date I ever.
Andrea, are you okay? Andrea, are you okay?
I got hit by a cop on a Segway last Halloween. Oh, I was wearing nothing but dolphin shorts and a feather green boa. I tried to steal his hat. Cut to weekend in Cabo. Then he went back to his dumb wife because I'm fat.
Who are you again?
Ah, it's D-Rock, you'll love him.
Hi, Jane. If you're wondering how my new roommate is, she's awesome. I just called to say that I'm glad it all worked out for you, and I really like that tank top on you.
Thanks, Samantha. Wait, how do you know what I'm wearing?
Your awesome Samantha makes a living by moving in with cute girls, setting up webcams, and charging people to watch.
Oh my God. That's why she wanted to eat popsicles and have a cream cheese fight yesterday.
Oh yeah, that's a popular one.
Wait, how did you find this?
Oh my God.
I know.
Wait, how did you find this?
Just a pop-up on another thing I was looking at.
What other thing?
Cooking blog? Sports?
Oh, my name.
Look, why don't you just ask Jane if you can borrow her nanny cam?
Why does Jane have a nanny cam?
Because I like to know what our stuff is doing when we're not here. Okay, we had some workers that I didn't trust, and then I just kind of fell in love with the teddy bear, so I left it there.
So you're trying to catch Brad doing something?
Yes, damn it, why hasn't it worked yet? Hey, honey.
Hi, babe.
So I hope your niece likes the teddy bear, and just remember there's only 8 gigabytes of hugs to give.
So what are you trying to film?
What? Do you know about the teddy cam?
Of course. But it's cool. I learned how to use it to my advantage.
Hey, babe. Max found this place with the best prime rib in the city. Now, it's in a strip club, but I promise you, I'm just going there for lunch.
Of course, boo.
Now, did you tell her that?
Okay, I did, but only because she shared so much. I mean, I had to say something.
Yeah, but couples therapy?
I don't know. Couples therapy.
Right? Us? Couples therapy? That's crazy. Woman, what did you do?
Technically, we did not go, but after Alex and Dave split up, I was so freaked out, I wanted to go see a couples therapist to make sure we were okay, so I thought I'd meet a few, you know, see who fit.
Wait, you auditioned therapists? How many?
Five.
Five?
Five! See, I thought maybe we had trouble communicating, but the first doctor said we just had different styles, and then, well, the second one said that, you know, I needed to bring up issues sooner and he had bad breath, and then the third one looked like a female Scott Bakula, which just stressed me out because I am way behind on my men of a certain ages, and you know how Mama likes a clean DVR. And then the fourth one asked me why I went to so many therapists, did not like him at all. And then the fifth one made me realize that I have an amazing husband and a great marriage. So all is good in the neighborhood.
Good. Great.
Okay, you're mad, but I wouldn't have had to go to all these therapists if I thought that you'd be open to it.
Oh, so now it's on me. Okay. All right. Fine.
Where are you going?
To work, because my wife is insane.
I am not insane. Okay, doctors 1, 3, and 5 confirmed that.
What are we watching, and why are you carrying around a teddy bear?
Don't worry about Murray the bear. He's with me. Oh. And Alex told me about your sleepwalking, and I am willing to bet that this tape proves that you stole the friggin' food.
She told you about that?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, I do not sleepwalk. I don't know why everybody... Ah! I sleepwalk.
Boom! Gotcha. See, you're gonna go to the fridge. Soon you're gonna go, and you're walking away from the fridge. Well, who stole the food then?
And why was I bowing? Wait, stop. Did you see that? Huh? Go back! Go back!
I'm going back!
Okay.
Dude, is there a guy living in our ceiling?
Yes, dude, there's a guy living in our ceiling.
I'm so proud of you. He seems so great. Ugh, what I wouldn't give to find a nice, normal guy. Hey, nerds. I got huge news. Okay, Dave,
I really hope you can be mature about this. So, I may have pushed Alex to go on her first date post the whole non-wedding thing. Are you cool with that?
Yeah, I'm totally cool with that.
Are you sure? Drew's gotta be kinda tough.
No, it's totally easy for me. Is he handsome? Successful? That doesn't matter. Is he tall?
He's actually your neighbor. He's that kinda cute, scruffy guy. He said he lived upstairs. Where have you been hiding him?
Oh my god, what have I done?
Set up Alex with a homeless squatter?
A homeless vigilante squatter.
We have to stop this.